Microsoft 365 Business Premium includes Defender for Office 365 Plan 1. When combined with the Exchange Online Protection, which comes with Exchange Online plans, can provide a powerful shield against phishing scams, spam, and malware. We're going to walk through how to get the most out of this protection stack. We are taking a best-in-suite approach with M365 Business Premium by focusing our efforts on the most optimal configuration of the tools, as this is what will prevent most business email compromise attacks. Business Premium includes Defender for Office 365 Plan 1. The main benefits of this are safe attachments and safe links. When you combine this with the standard Exchange Online Protection features, you can create a very robust anti-spam solution for your business. I always believe that configuring the tools you have available to you properly is the most effective way to prevent business email compromise. This page on the MS Learn site gives you an overview of the entire protection stack on both plans and what each feature does. I highly recommend you review this before you implement these features, and you can always review the diagram at the bottom to get an overview. It's important to realize that these settings below are interdependent building blocks that work together to provide the best possible email protection against spoofing and phishing attacks. Anything less than all of the email authentication methods available results in substandard protection. Sender Policy Framework is a method of email authentication that helps external recipients validate mail sent from your Microsoft 365 organization was authorized to do so. We use it to prevent spoof senders that are used in business email compromise attacks, ransomware, and other phishing attacks. The SPF record is a text record that gets added through your domain management service. When you add a custom domain to M365, the wizard would try to guide you to add this as you go. You can check it's there using command prompt afterwards. As we can see, we have the text record that says V equals SPF1, which indicates it's an SPF record, and then include, and then the service that is allowed to send email on behalf of our domain. You might have additional services that want to send email from your business domain, and they need to be added inside the SPF record, or they may get marked as spam. This might be custom web servers, for instance, an e-shop, marketing services that send large amounts of outbound email, but not from Exchange Online, or other stuff that is similar. Domain keys identified mail uses a domain to digitally sign important elements of a message to ensure the message has not been altered in transit. There's no additional cost with configuring DKIM, and with M365, it can be done very quickly. From the Defender portal, if I go down to email collaboration, policies and rules, threat policies, email authentication settings, DKIM, we'll be able to see all the domains we've got registered in our M365 tenant and their status on DKIM. When you add a new domain to your M365 tenant these days, it will prompt you during the setup to do DKIM as you do it. But for domains that haven't got that, you can go to this side of the portal and you can enable it. If I click Enable, I can then click into the domain and I get instructions here to publish some CNAMEs at my DNS hosting provider, with the host names being selector 1 and selector 2 and values listed below. Once you add those and commit them, come back here within a few hours, and when you click on it, you'll see the status is signing DKIM signatures for this domain, and that's all you need to do. I recommend externally validating your DKIM records once they've been created. There are many free online tools to do this. You simply enter your domain and select a 1, and we validate. This one says success. And I can do select a 2 as well. And this one's also successful. So we've done SPF and DKIM, and to complete the triangle of outbound email security tasks, we should look at DMARC, or Domain-Based Message Authentication, Reporting and Conformance. These specify the action for the messages that fail SPF or DKIM checks for the senders in your domain, and specifies where to send the DMARC results. We are instructing the potential recipient mail server what to do if our outbound SPF or DKIM don't match what's expected. And I really see this as doing your part for outbound email spam. And if everyone did this, there'd be a lot less spam going around. And it's really easy to set up, and there's no cost to it unless you choose to send the reports to a third-party service, which often has a web dashboard that you can view and review your outbound email. I've got Notepad open to show us what a DMARC record looks like. It's something that you configure completely outside of Microsoft 365 in your domain console, and I'll explain the elements now. V equals DMARC1 tells us the type of the record. P is the policy, and that can be none, quarantine, or reject. It's recommended that you start in none, because if you do quarantine or reject, and there are legitimate business services that you've not quite uncovered that don't have DKIM or SPF correctly configured, it will send those emails to the recipient junk or quarantine folders. Percentage is the percent of the emails it should apply to. RUA, A is the aggregate report, and RUF, F is the forensic report, and then you can enter a custom email address in here. Now, I highly recommend investing or going to find a third-party service that will parse these reports for you and display them in a nice web page, because they're very unhuman readable and can be quite difficult to interpret what's going on. SP is the subdomain policy, and we've got that set to none. And the forensic options is set to 1, and that means if SPF or DKIM fail, then it should report. For domains in M365 that aren't sending email, you can still set SPF records and DMARC records and instruct the DMARC record in such a way which says that no email should ever come from it. And the way you do that is by changing the policy to very, very short and setting it to reject. DMARC checks on mail coming into Microsoft 365 are affected by the following features in Exchange Online Protection, which both live in anti-phishing. That's in Policies and Rules, Threat Policies, Anti-Phishing. The first one is Spoof Intelligence. And the second one are the actions down here about whether or not to honour the DMARC policy in certain situations. Audit logging is turned on by default for Microsoft 365 organisations. Microsoft Purview Auditing Solutions provide an integrated solution to help organisations effectively respond to security events, forensic investigations, internal investigations, and compliance obligations. Thousands of user and admin operations performed in dozens of Microsoft services and solutions are captured, recorded, and retained in your organisation's unified audit log. Audit records for these events are searchable by security ops, IT admins, insider risk teams, and compliance and legal investigators in your business. This capability provides visibility into the activities performed in your organization. With SPF, DKIM, and DMARC sorted, along with auditing, how do we now protect our users from inbound spam, phishing, and malware attempts? We go to Defender Portal, and then down to Email Collaboration, Policies and Rules. Threat policies. This is where you control how Exchange Online Protection and Defender for Office work together to protect your users from threats. You can do this by setting manual policies, such as anti-phishing, spam, malware, and then using the two main features of Defender for Office 365 Plan 1, Safe Attachments and Safe Links. If you already have a tenant which you manage, I'd recommend looking at the Configuration Analyzer. This will look at your current policy, and if it's named differently, see we've got the policy column, it will pick up your custom names, and it will check the current configuration of that item, and when you click into something, it recommends what you should do. This is a very easy way to get yourself up to a much better standard of email security using the products that are already in your subscription. If you're setting up for the first time, or would like a quicker approach and you're prepared to ditch your existing settings, you can use the preset security policies. And there are three levels. Built-in is non-negotiable. You have standard, and you have strict. All of these settings are on the MS Learn site, but let's have a look at standard protection and we'll apply that to this tenant. If I toggle the switch on, or click Manage Protection Settings, I can now go through a wizard to apply this. I want the Exchange Online Protection to apply to all recipients. I want Defender for Office 365 to also apply to all recipients. And impersonation protection, we should consider those who may be at most risk of impersonation, such as C-levels or non-exec directors, those types of people. So, you add the name. And you add the email. If you have custom domains, as it says here, domains that belong to your key suppliers or partners, you can add them here as well. And what this essentially does is make the defender mechanism and the detection engines pay a bit closer attention to domains that might try and spoof the ones you add here. So I might try to add contoso.com. And you can add trusted senders, not to add or flag as being impersonated, if they already look pretty similar to your internal contacts. But I'm not going to do that one for now. I'm going to turn the policy on. And one more chance to review my settings before I click confirm. Now, it's important that since we selected all users, that all users have the correct license to use the protection features. This, of course, does not affect any other custom policies you'd like to make or change here. But you can see it's created standard preset security policy and it's got the logo there from what we've just seen. It may still be applying as we've only just hit go.